That way of thinking is what's getting y'all into deep shit. You need to work on your soft skills. Being caring, docile, willing to sacrifice your short-term pleasure for long-term pleasure. You know who it'd be? Choose yourself up. This video topic will be about. Ladies, marriage is an investment. Not a fairy tale. Let's get into it. Can I tell what a couple of you might be thinking? Might be saying, spamming in the comment section. No, I've never been married. I've seen many people get married though. I've seen the numbers, I've seen the basic stats, and I've also seen what y'all want, what y'all say, how y'all act. When I mean y'all, I mean, yes, I'm talking to the women. Yes, I'm talking about women. The point of the video, ladies, is to show you that it is not all about you. It's not all about me. I want this, I want that. And you don't bring anything in return. Ladies, it is not a fairy tale. If you just want to get married for the sake of getting married, or because people are telling you to get married, then you're the last person to get married. If you are in your young 20s, you better be working on finding yourself a man. A man that you actually like, a man that's going somewhere, a man that's going places, and a man that can satisfy you. Because see, I don't care. I'm gonna say the cold hard truth. You are a depreciating asset. As you grow older, your options will dwindle lower and lower and lower. See, if you're in your 20s, you won't believe what I'm saying. Ladies who are in their 30s, ladies who are in their mid-30s and late 40s, and so on. You know what I'm talking about. You know about the changes in attention, the changes in benefits you've had when you were young to now when you're old. How about y'all be honest and educate the young girls, like, hey, you need to find yourself someone you like before you hit the wall. Because ladies, the wall is coming. And as you grow older, it's harder to find a man you actually like. Because youth is something men seek. And if you want a man that you actually like, which means he's a high value, attractive, has something going for him, he's gonna value that youth. So if you want to get married, you need to, one, be actually made for it. Now, what do I mean by that? Yes, first of all, you need to know that it's an investment. You're investing time, years, effort, energy, resources, time, probably said that already, with this man. For what purpose? Like, this is why I asked, why do you want to get married? Because it's a fairy tale, like you have to go through that process. Most of marriages get divorced, 90% of the time, by the woman. Take your feelings out of your asses, ladies, and listen. You initiate most of the divorces. So why get married? It means 9 out of 10 women, in the first year of marriage, divorce. That is, what I'm saying. 3/4 of marriages are divorced by a woman. There, that makes more sense. That's showing that women don't even know what they want and that they're rushing into marriages. Y'all are rushing into marriages even though it's not good for you, even though you don't know the purpose of it, even though you haven't built the soft skills. Because you can say you are the perfect catch 10 out of 10. You can say it all you want. You can be delusional as much as you want, okay, sweethearts? But the fact of the matter is, if you don't have what it takes, you won't cut it. See, men work in a world of probability. Women work in a world of hopes. I hope. Men work on, this is the odds of it working out. So, that way of thinking is what's getting y'all into deep shit. You need to work on your soft skills. Being caring, docile, willing to sacrifice your short-term pleasure for long-term pleasure. Because see, marriage is between two people here. If you're not capable of thinking about someone else besides yourself, you will not hold a man. And if the man is anything of value, he will sure as hell not pick you or be loyal to you. He won't. So you'll end up alone, and he'll find someone better. Because men, we grow our value as we get older. We get more resources, we look older, we look more attractive. Gray hairs are hella attractive on men, not on women. So, what can you do, ladies, to improve your situation and understand what you can do? I'll tell you what you can do. Start young. Every girl who are in their 20s, get your asses into the gym. I don't give a shit. It's very easy. You girls only need to do like one quarter of the workouts and the effort it takes to get an attractive body. If you can't do that, then you're just lazy, and then it's all on you. But here's another thing. Having the body and the looks doesn't cut it. Marriage, it's a long-term commitment to dealing with the same person day in and day out. On days you're happy, on days you're sad, on days you're annoyed. Things you want to do? This is a high-value man, of course. Because all of you girls, don't want to deal with a low-value man. You want to deal with someone on your level or higher. Most of the time, higher. Then you have to do things that most girls won't do. Unless it's a high-value man. See, there's a lot of girls out there who are willing to do whatever it takes to get a high-value man. Are you, though? Like, having sex when you're not in the mood. Like, dealing with him being away. Not giving you lots of time or attention. Or not giving you lots of sex. Because, see, high-value men need to work a lot. A lot. I mean a lot. Can you handle that? Can you handle not inviting any other guys out to come over, to go out? Can you handle not giving your attention to other men or giving the opportunity of you cheating with other men when your husband isn't around? Can you handle that? Can you do that? Can you be soft and caring even when you don't feel like it? Can you? Can you cook a meal? Because if the man's out working every single day, coming back home early or late, tired as fuck, and you sitting there waiting to order food, he's not gonna want to keep you. See, these are basic skills right here. It's not a fairy tale, ladies. You don't get married and then live happily ever after. Fairy tale films like Disney does not show you the end game of how things become. After that, they live happily ever after. What's those characters' names again? Beauty and the Beast? In the house, you know, dealing with the basic ass lives. Over and over and over again. She still needs to hold up her end of the bargain. He still needs to hold up his end of the bargain. Doing things you don't like. Routines. Getting to arguments. Getting the bedroom. Skipping out in the bedroom. The boring, basic things. Like, think about that. It's not anything special. It doesn't change anything in your life. Nothing at all. Stop thinking it's a fairy tale that the man needs to do everything and you just sit there looking pretty. Do that, you're waiting for a disaster. You're waiting for being single in your 40s. But hey, if that's what you want, go for it. Go for it. But ladies, it's an investment. It takes time, effort, work, building skills early. Any woman who says, I can build my skills when I start marrying, I can build my skills when I'm with him, that's bullshit. You wanna know why? It's like a man saying, oh, I can be masculine when I'm with the right woman. Until then, I'll be super feminine. That doesn't make any goddamn sense, and you know it. So, no, that's not an excuse. You want to get married? You want to be a woman worth marrying for a high-value man? Work on your skills. Be smart. Be educated to a certain level. Have character. Stay fit. Work on your home skills. Because if you're going to be a wife and the man needs to pay for everything, that's what high-value men do. You need to be, you know, giving something in return. Otherwise, you'll find another girl who can. See, girls, y'all don't get it's 90 to 80% of y'all are going for the top 10 to 20% of men. You're fighting with your 8 of your sisters for the same men. So if you're not giving something more than just looking pretty, you're not gonna cut it. Cause see, if you're just coming with looks and sex, you're not gonna cut it. Cause as you grow older, there's every single day there's a girl turning 18 who's looking for a sugar daddy, was looking for men. Every single day there are girls turning to such an age who are younger than you, prettier than you, and who can offer more than most of you. Listen, it's not your fault. It's the whole bullshit of people telling you you don't have to work for shit. You do have to work. Just that men's time is later in life, so women's time is earlier. If you want stuff that you actually like, and you want to set up your life to a way you want, and you want to get married, and you want it, even if it doesn't make any logical sense inside your heads or at all, even if you're not the type of woman who deserves to get married, if you want to get married, you need to bring something more. Old school soft skills, femininity. Yo, if you're feminine and you can be docile or caring as a woman, you already are advanced way in front of most of the other women. You see, a feminine docile woman is rare, and they're more likely to get chosen for marriage. I don't care how shallow that sounds, that's the truth. It's not about what I want, this and that. Enjoy the fairy tale, I'll pay for everything, yada yada yada, be in debt. No. Get your ass out of here with that. You have to be building yourself up to a certain way. You can't be going out every single night, having partying, doing drugs, alcohol, crazy orgies, all that crap. Yeah, super fun, cool, super fun. But then after, you're gonna be building your weight and your mindset to a certain lifestyle that marriage is not compatible with at all. And see, men, we're good at detecting if a woman's meant for certain material, whether girlfriend, quick fuck, or marriage. And see, most women are not meant for marriage. Because most women are doing the same thing. What is that? Not being cooperative, not being feminine, not taking care of their bodies, not building soft home skills that a high value man would want from a wife. You need to work on these skills right here. These are your bread and butter right here. Your bread and butter for being a wife that a high value man would choose. Otherwise, you're gonna keep on hoping and being played by Chad and Tyrone. But no one's gonna be sad for you. Cause see, there's something called consequences for your actions. Choose the life you wanna live. Girl, choose the life you wanna live. Go for it. But you cannot complain when the life you chose isn't what you wanted. Alright? Remember, it's an investment. You're two people. They need to be with each other long term. One of you is going to be worth more than the other one. Long term, the man's worth more than the woman. Long term, if you have a high value man, you need to be keeping that high value man. While other girls who are younger, more attractive, and more sexual are trying to take him from you. Keep that in mind, ladies. Keep that in mind. So don't forget to like the video, share, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.